Hello students, hope you all enjoying my videos and hope it will benefit your studies. And my videos are from this first history of Southeast Asia. And in my earlier videos, I just told you about the colonial rule of Burma. And today I'm going to tell you about the history of Siam. And we call it as Thailand now. So, and especially in Siam, I will tell you about the rule of Rama V in Siam. And he was a ruler of a Chakri dynasty. And as we all know that he was the son of Rama IV, King Mongkut. And King Mongkut was in very much favor of modernization of Thai society. And he was very much impressed by the Western system of education. And in King Mongkut, along with his son Chulalongkorn, he went to Malaya Peninsula to watch solar eclipse. When they returned, they both fell ill, and King Mongkut could not survive, and he died in 1868. And Chulalongkorn recovered himself from the disease, from the illness of cholera. But there's a background of it. The most powerful official of the Siam, Prime Minister Suri Yong, was in misconception that Chulalongkorn will not survive and he could face death. So he managed himself for the regent position, and he also managed to make Via Chiachan, that was Chulalongkorn's cousin, as an heir apparent. And he was in misconception that if Chulalongkorn would die and he would become the heir, the king, so he could be manipulated. But the things went upright, and the Rama V, and you can say that Chulalongkorn recovered. And in 1868, he was given, at the age of 15, he was announced as the heir of the throne. And while he was minor, he was given the time to learn about the government, how to govern the country. He went to Java and he came to India also to learn how the Western colonial powers rule their countries, how the British ruled India. So he was the first monarch to go outside Siam to learn. And he was also given the lessons by the Western tutor, Leonor Wells. She was the governor of Chulalongkorn also, and his younger brothers also. And later on in his rule, you can see the reflection of the tuitions, reflections of the he got from his governess. And when he was crowned in 1873, he made a lot of reforms. He was very much famous for the reforms. He announced the ban of prostration, you can say Shashtang Pranam, in front of royal personage. And that was a very good step taken by Chulalongkorn. And later on, he announced the total abolition, not the total, the slight abolition of serfdom. And as he knew that if he will abolish it gradually, because he was experienced, and he knew that in some of the countries when it was abolished at random, civil war broke out. So the total abolition was in 1905, but he announced in 1873 only. And he made lot of reforms in judiciary. He made lot of reforms in legislature, and as well as in executive. And the result was that his cousin, who was a prince, Via Chiachan, you can he rebelled a conservative party formed conservative party and they revolted against these reforms. And this prince went to the Britain and France also for the protection. But the thing was that the British and France both refused to give protection to him. And they said that it is their internal affair. So the Chulalongkorn was able to manipulate to subside this revolt. But the result consequence was that the whole of the cabinet was disbanded and they were ceased to meet. So he could not make the reform, continue with his reform policy for a decade. For 10 years, it was a very hard time for King Rama V.